Hello everyone, my name is Jocklington and welcome back to another GTA 5 video. Now you may realize that something crazy has happened. I have changed my floral pattern shirt to another floral pattern shirt. But that's not what today's video is about. So let's get to it. Today we will be customizing the Anis CR350, also known as the Mazda RX-7 in real life. And yeah, let's just get right into it. Looks very cool, this car, but I'm really looking forward to tuning it actually, because you know it wouldn't be GTA if we just had the stock cars. I mean, they look way better customized. So let's get into it. I have already put on the cosmetic upgrades, so let's put on the visual stuff. Front bumpers, vented street, ways cutout, painted cutout, and tuner bumper. All very nice actually. I'm not sure which one I want to go with. I'm pretty sure these lights actually work, so I don't want to get rid of those using this bumper. But I think I like this street bumper. Kind of makes it look like a Mazda Miata a little bit. Let's choose that one. Rear bumpers, rear diffuser, and primary tip diffuser. Not very many options, and I don't really think this diffuser works on the car. It's very large, so let's leave that stuck. Engine block. Zoom in like this. Of course, we have the rotary engine in there. Very nice. Primary engine, secondary. I think I'm gonna leave it chrome, like that. Air filters. Primary, secondary, ways, primary, performance, secondary, performance, and ways, performance, air intake, and primary turbo. We can add a turbo. Amazing. I think I'm gonna go with the, the primary turbo air intake system. That looks very nice, and I really like the way we get the anis on the, I think that's the intercooler. I don't really know, but that looks very nice. Let's choose that. Strut brace. Since we already have one, we might as well change it a little bit, make it look better. I think let's choose this one, the extreme billet strut brace. Kind of nice. Or does it actually, let's see, does it clip in? The stuck one doesn't, so maybe that, I don't really know, that I don't really mind. It's not like we're gonna be looking in the engine bay all the time. Let's choose the extreme build strut brace. Engine tunes, already tuned that up. Intercoolers. Oh, that's the intercooler. Then I guess this up was the radiator. I'm not sure. I'm gonna stop talking on so it doesn't screw up. Small logo, large logo, intercooler with twin fans, and with water sprayer. Might just put on the custom intercooler. Yeah, let's do that. Exhaust. Let's see. Street exhaust. Titanium tipped. Dual titanium. Dual exhaust. Square exit. Angled exit. Angled exit alt. Angled blast pipes. And straight blast pipes. Not too sure actually. I might go with the street exhaust just because I think two exhaust pipes works a lot better than four in this car, so let's choose that. Fenders! Primary bolted, can make a wide body, I guess. Carbon bolted. Primary front, also wide body. And the rear. I think I'm gonna leave it stuck, maybe. It looks a little bit weird with it on, in my opinion, so let's leave it stuck. Headlights. Sleepy eyes and drowsy eyes. I don't really know why you would choose that, and if I'm not mistaken, the lights actually don't work if you choose any of these. So I prefer to have the pop-up headlights work. So let's just leave them how they are. Hood catches, primary, secondary hood pins, angled, all sorts of stuff. I'm not gonna put any of those on as usual. Now hood, see-through hood. Didn't we have another car with this option? I don't actually remember. Looks very weird. Carbon stock, ripped hood. I guess these lines here, that's quite nice actually. Carbon whipped, ripped hood alt. Just another version. That in carbon cutting vent. Carbon cutting trident. Kidney vented, that looks weird. And fully vented, that looks really weird. How does that even... I mean, that doesn't look very good. This is actually a hard one. I kind of like most of them. I think I'm gonna go with the... let's see, the whipped hood. I really like those lines. It really adds to the car. Kind of complements the... yeah, the lines of the car. So let's choose that. Interior. Let's see. Dash. Street interior. Semi-stripped. Race dash. And carbon dash. What does this look like from the outside? Let's see. So the semi-stripped adds some stuff back here. And that's mostly the same, other than this thing here is a little bit different. I don't really know why it is like that. But let's see again. I think I'm gonna go with the street interior. Maybe. Yeah, I'm not sure actually. I might kind of like it stuck. Does it do anything else? Yeah, because if you look this texture, I actually prefer the stock texture, so let's leave it stock. Dials, single taco, dash gauges, but on this, I think I like the single boost gauge actually. Let's leave that in. Doors, all of the usual door handles. Door cards, I guess. Gonna leave the stock because it's the most normal looking one. Seats, sports seats. Painted carbon. Ballistic tuna seats. Bucket seats and track seats. Carbon race seats. I might go with some bucket seats. I'm not sure what color I'm gonna choose yet on this car, but let's go with the carbon bucket seat with the wedge seat belts. I don't think they're called seat belts, but let's move on. Steering wheel, definitely gonna choose or change this one. This looks horrendous. Something I would like. Looks like something you would find on a muscle car. Let's see, what options do we have? I mean, I know what options we have. These are the ones we always have. But I think I'm gonna go with the Rally Clubman. Yeah, that looks nice. Let's choose that. Roll cage. Street roll cage. Racer cage. Secondary. And racer roll cage. I'm not gonna put any of these on. It kind of don't really look that great. Yeah, gonna leave that stock. Lights. Headlights, you can see the pop-up headlights looking beautiful. Leave them the way they are. Livery, classic racing stripes. Again, why do you... I always order the cars in white and you can't actually see the white liveries. Let's change that to silver real quick. And go back to livery. Classic racing stripes, just some white stripes, looks very nice. Anise stripes. Kind of cool how it actually goes around to fit the car. Let's see, shopping list, very simple, and the same in white. It's a Kua tree, that's really cool. I don't think I've ever seen a livery like that. Very cool. Spunk. And this one. And very interesting color combination on this. And the same in white. I prefer it in white, to be honest. Atomic Drift Team. Kisama Chiffons. Very cool. Winning is winning. Anna's racing drive. That's a cool livery. And the alternative version also very cool. Do we want to put livery on it? I kind of like the secure tree, but I don't really know how I would make that work. I might come back to the liveries, to be honest, because I'm not really sure on those yet. Lures, primary and carbon. I'm not gonna put that on. Mirrors, tuna mirrors, and front mounted. I don't really like the front mounted. I don't really like the stock ones either, so let's choose the tuna mirrors. Blade, gonna leave that how it is. Respray, what color? Looks very nice and black, to be honest. Let's see. What color would look good on this? Probably any color, to be honest. You know, I might go with a graphite or something like that. It's been a while since I've done that, and I think this car could really suit it. Maybe, I mean, graphite is very dark. Maybe something like black steel? Maybe even dark steel. Yeah, let's choose dark steel. That looks very nice, actually. Secondary, what is the secondary? Brake calipers. And the stitching. How would this look in wet? Let's just take a look. Find the wet. Looks, the brake calipers looks quite nice. And we have the wet stitching with the wet seat belts. That looks very nice. I'm definitely going to choose that. And let's see. Trim. It's the surrounding. Or the, I don't really know what you call that. And the seats. I'm gonna leave it how it is, this dark steel sort of color. Accent color is the gauge color, but not the boost color, that's interesting. Gonna leave it how it is. And roof. Race roof scoop, carbon, and tuna. Carbon tuna. I don't think I'm gonna put a roof scoop on it. Skirts. Street skirts, kind of hard to see with this color, but let's see. Street skirts, carbon street skirts, tuna, carbon tuna, ways, vented. I wonder if any of these would actually go with the wide body fenders. And competition, I think they do actually. Custom skirts, extended skirts, carbon. Oh, we actually get some stuff down there as well. It's cool. I guess that would really work with the wide body. Do I want to put a wide body on it now, actually, that we have some skirts that kind of match? Let's just, let's give it a try, you know. I very rarely do wide body cars, but let's see at least how it looks with the back fenders. That looks very nice, actually. Let's choose that. What about the front fenders? Not really too sure on this right here. You know what? Let's do it. Where did they go? Primary front fenders. Let's put that on. I just want to take a look at the back bumper again. Yeah, that still doesn't look very nice. Let's just move on then. Down to the splitters. Ooh, front splitter. Plastic, secondary. Oh, and red. Doesn't look very good, actually. Primary. Street splitter with canards. Primary tipped. Carbon race. Primary canards. Secondary carbon. Or secondary canards. That's red. Wanna keep it fairly simple, I think. So we'll go with the. Probably just the plastic splitter, to be honest. Yeah, let's choose the plastic splitter. Spoiler. Oh yes, thank you very much. I really don't like this car without a spoiler, so let's just have a quick roll through. Having it weird, that doesn't look very nice. Street spoiler, carbon tuna, carbon race, carbon and competition spoiler, big wing, carbon big wing, rear mounted spoiler, and a rear mounted spoiler alt. Some very crazy spoiler options for this car, but I think I wanna choose the optional spoiler. It's just the right size for this car. Sun strips, primaries, plastic, white Fuguru, black, white mind marked, and power homes. Now, I mean, I actually sort of like. You know, I might also come back to that if you find the livery for it, because it kind of suits the car in my opinion. Suspension already slammed. Tail lights. Green, red, yellow, blue, and iridescent. If I'm pronouncing it correctly. You know? Doesn't look too bad with those color. This color glass. You know, I think I'm just gonna keep it the way it is. I kinda like how black and dark the original wheel lights are. So let's just move on. Already tinted the windows and wheels. I really don't like the wheels on this car by stock, so let's find some new ones in the track category, hopefully. Ooh, this looks very nice, and the lights came on for some reason. I think it's might have been going to nighttime outside. Let's see. Oh, the pure business ones look very nice. And these are the deluxe ones. Let's just have a look at Fuhrwerk again. Split star. Beat boy. Actually really like the split star. I think I'm gonna go with those. I really think they suit the car, and let's make them black. Oh, this car looks so good. I've never actually been that much of a fan of the RX-7, but just seeing this car and DJ with this color combo and the options looks very nice. Let's see the liveries again. White stripes, the yellow, the black stripe, shopping list, secure tree. It would also have some the spoiler, that's cool. Maybe just the white stripes, actually. I would have liked to have seen that option in black. I mean, they're usually in both options. You could also do the shopping list, but that's very simple. I guess you could choose this one as well. I'm not too sure, actually. I think, though, however, I like the white stripes on it. I really don't know, actually. This stripe is also kind of cool. You know, I think I'm gonna keep it simple and go with the shopping list. You rarely go wrong with that. And let's just go a look, have a look at the sun strips again. And now we actually get anise on top there by choosing this livery. I don't think I'm gonna put a sunstrip on it, to be honest. I kinda like how it is without it. Just wanted to see if there was a bumper option that matched this a little bit better, but it doesn't look like it. So yeah, I guess that's gonna be it. It's very happy with how this turned out, actually. Let's just roll it into the garage and have a little look before we drive it for a test one. And let's get outside and take a look. Oh yes. It looks very nice, actually. It turned out way better than I thought it would. Why does this have anise in white with the black livery? I don't really know that. But anyways, let's have a test drive. And it's night time, of course. I think I started tuning it when it was daytime, so I must have spent too long or something. But yeah. Yeah, we do have the secondary lights down there, and it looks very nice. With the power-up headlights, I really love that. But yeah, let's just take a look at the interior. Can't really see it, but I like the option with the wet stitching and the wet seat belts and stuff. But yeah, let's drive it. Sounds very, very nice. Really liking how it sounds. And yeah, also how it looks. It's not very often, as I said earlier, I go with a color like this, but on this car, looks very nice. Yeah. But let's roll up somewhere and have a look at the interior and all the stuff we usually look at. Let's go into a Davis Mega Mall and park it up right here. Very cool. That looks great. That's not the phone I want. I want this thing up here. Let's open up all the doors. Let's lower it. Oh yes, it looks great lowered. And let's turn it on. Very nice. We have the engine in here. Let's just get my flashlight out. With the anise intercooler. I think a radiator, I'm not too sure. And a beautiful rotary engine. Very nice. I think it's the first time we have that engine option actually. We have the interior. With the black and the red stitching and the red seat belts. Looks very, very nice. I'm really happy with the interior on this car. And of course we have the boot. Very dark. Can't really see anything. And very large. Very cool. Let's open or close the doors again. Like that. And let's have a little drive. Again, I guess. What would be cool if we could actually change the color of the needles in the gauges. That could be very nice. But maybe someday. Oh, it really likes the drift when lowered. Very nice. It's a great drifter, actually. I mean, I guess you would expect it to be, considering what it is, but yeah, I'm really happy with this, how this car turned out. But yeah, that's gonna be it for this video, guys, where we checked out the Anise CR350, also known as the Mazda RX-7. Mostly known as the Mazda RX-7. But yeah, I hope you have enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one, I guess. Goodbye. We'll be right back.